This video is brought to you by Squarespace. A few months back, I made a video introducing my minimalist desk setup. And in between, I've made a few changes, removed a few things, and also added some. I shall call it a mini makeover. Hi, I'm CK Space. In this video, I'll show you some of the changes I've made on my minimalist workspace. And why do voiceover always sounds like this for a desk setup video? I don't know, who cares, let's carry on. Okay, first thing first. One thing I can't stand in this room is the cracked walls. And you might not even realize this in my video. I know, I can forcefully say that it's wabi-sabi. But they can be pretty messy in the background, so I have to scrape away all the loose layer, even them out, and put a layer of putty. Lastly, paint a new coat of paint. And you guys guess, what's the color of my new room? Alright, who am I kidding? It's obviously white. Don't expect too much from a minimalist. By the way, I've changed my table's position from facing the window to facing the wall. I always wanted to do that, but my previous table was too long for that. And now with my current table, it fits nicely into this wall niche. And yes, I also just realized there's a name for this hole. To be honest, I love to face the window, but I get distracted by the things outside of my window easily. So now I'll just turn to the right and have a glance at those trees when I'm having a quick break. I'll be lying if I say that's the main reason, because the ultimate objective here is to hide those atrocious power sockets located on the wall. And since I rarely use my TV, I've removed it. Then I realized it's kind of weird to have a random shelf at the center of the room. So I shifted it across on top of my monitor. My Jean Julian print has always been on the floor, and now it's mounted up on the wall, which saves a lot of floor space in the room. All those dirty and dusty jobs are done here. Let us get into the desk setup. My table is still the same old dining table from IKEA. And for the chair, it's something new. I think that's one of the most asked questions from you guys. What is this chair? But before we continue, a quick message from our sponsor for this video, Squarespace. Living in this digital world, and especially during times like this, we need a space where we can display our skills on a website. And Squarespace is perfect for that. They have powerful blogging tools for you to build your community. If you want an e-commerce website, they have all the tools you need. From managing inventory, promoting your products, and all the technical stuff you wouldn't want to be bothered by. All you have to do is choose their aesthetically pleasing, award-winning template, and then share your ideas to the world. It's as simple as that. If that's something you are looking for, go to squarespace.com/ckspace to get your free trial running. And when it's ready to launch, use the code CKSpace to get 10% off your first purchase. Once again, huge thanks to Squarespace for keeping the lights on. And let us carry on. When it comes to chair, I used to sit on an Ames-looking plastic chair. It's fine, but it's not the best if you have to sit on it almost 24/7. And due to the height of the chair and table, I had been feeling a lot of pain on my shoulder, neck, and forearm. I can't totally blame the chair, because it's also the way I sit that is detrimental to my body. And this new chair was a gift from my girlfriend. It's an ergonomic chair from a local brand in Singapore, ErgoTune, and I have been eyeing this chair for a long while. I'll say it's a pretty typical ergonomics chair. You have all the adjusting functions, roller wheels, adjustable seat height, depth, armrest height, width, length, angle, backrest height, and also it's reclinable with lumbar support. And of course, a mesh cushion, which is important for a hot climate like Singapore. There's nothing nasty for me to complain about this chair. Any upgrade is better than my previous chair. And it was a surprise gift from my girlfriend, so what more can I say? Now with this, I can sit at a perfect height for this table without straining my shoulders. However, I need a footrest before my leg turned purple. I've tried stepping on stacked books, but I think it makes my desk setup too messy. And I don't really like the idea of stepping on books, so I got myself an extremely bulky footrest with adjustable height. By the way, what's on top of my desk are still the same monitor and my 11-year-old speakers. With this new chair to help with my posture, it became another issue because now my monitor is too low for my eyes, and I have to look downwards all the time, and my neck hasn't been in the best shape lately. Not to mention, I'd want to cultivate a front-tilting neck. That's why I need to elevate the monitor according to my eye level. And GrowthMate was kind enough to send me one of their walnut monitor stand to elevate my monitor to the perfect height. Beautifully made. And it's the little details that make a difference between this and other products. I love the quality of the material and its craftsmanship. But what I love the most is the space underneath the stand. A place where I can hide my messy hard disk. And now to my peripherals. My keyboard is still the same from Logitech. Still pretty difficult for me to type because of the narrow spacing. But I'm still gonna live with it. My previous mouse was down. I needed something bigger because my previous mouse was too small for me to hold on to for the whole day. I often find my pinky having weird cramps, as if it's auditioning for the main lead in the movie Exorcist. So it took me quite a while to upgrade to this Logitech MX Master 2S. I guess this mouse needs no introduction. An overrated mouse, to be honest. I got my second hand from a friend, and it's a pretty old model. So it's kind of affordable for the number of functions provided. I have a felt mat which was also gifted by GrowthMate, and it's long enough to be my mouse pad, desk mat, and a coaster for my morning coffee. It works perfectly fine to protect my table. But felt might not be the best material for me because I always eat in front of my desk, so it's kind of difficult to keep it clean all the time. However, I chose that because it's extremely useful when it comes to soundproofing when I'm doing voiceover. An IKEA lamp on the side, pointing at the back of my monitor, so that it's not too harsh for my vision. And it creates a backlit effect, which I love it. By the way, I have a few small tricks that can help to keep your desk minimal. For example, I hide my fan controller underneath the table. Also, to make my daily guitar practice more seamless, I have a guitar pick which is attached beside the table with a magnet. I stick a 3M Velcro on my phone cable, and it's attached to my phone stand, so it won't fall off the desk easily. Or sometimes I'll just let it hook onto the felt mat. To keep the tabletop neat and minimal, you might want to find ways to hide your tools without losing the ease of accessing them. Let's move to the shelf on top. It houses my favorite decorations, my self-made ink die and a textured paper. My favorite bronze clock, and also a box I keep my cable and hard disk which I rarely touch. If you watch my earlier videos, you might know I used to have some greens here and there to add life and color on my table, but I find that a little too messy and counterproductive. So I've been shifting them around. Currently on my desk, I'm left with this satin pothos, trailing down from the side. A lot of people asked how I watered this hanging plant. I know it's troublesome, but I have to bring it down whenever it needed water. What's underneath is my CPU, a subwoofer with an internet router sitting on top of it, a footrest, and also a dry cabinet for my camera gears. There wasn't a specific spot for my headphone previously. It used to be sitting around the room. When I needed them, then I'll plug it in. But not until recently, then I realized I can keep both my speakers and my headphone plugged in at the same time. Depending on what I need at the moment, whether it's my speaker or my headphone, I can control it just by switching on and off my speaker from the side. And when the headphone is not in use, it's resting on a hook mounted underneath my table. They say you can tell a person's personality just by looking in their bag. And I'll add, you can judge a person's character just by looking underneath their desk. Obviously, I'm not the best person you can get advice when it comes to cable management, but I have to say, it did improve a lot as compared to my previous effort. My cable management is supported by cable ties and wire ties. There isn't much space for me to hide them, so I bundled them up with wire ties and tie them with cable tie to the leg of my table. So basically, I flush them all the way to the side to create an illusion that it's clean below. That sounded really weird. The USB and SD card ports are velcroed on the side of the leg. I'll say it's the perfect spot to hide them, while still having easy access. I also utilize some of these hooks to keep those wires in place. So that's my mini room makeover and my desk setup update. When it comes to this change, I'll say it leans more towards the ergonomic and functionality side of things. How I can be productive and work comfortably at the same time. I have all the products linked in the description below, so if you're interested, you can check them out. I had a great time making this video, so I hope you enjoyed it as well. That's all I have for you guys, and I shall see you guys on the next.